It's gonna be business as usual.
Welcome back to this real shit. You made it. You're now tuned into the underworld's favorite.
I was about to do this Donda review. First of all, it's the guy G-Holy, repping G-Holy.com. Thank y'all all for tuning in, subscribing, the feedback. I love hip-hop conversation. Let's do it. I don't care how you feel. Let's do it. We can go. Trust me, I'm here. But, yeah, I was going to do this Kanye West Donda review, the leak review. First of all, I was just waiting for people to get it. I didn't know that many people didn't have it. You know what I mean? Like, because I had this leak for about maybe like close to a week now. And I'm waiting for people to like really get it so that I could do the, you know, the formal review. But I actually did a review on gholy.com, like a written review. So if you need to go more in depth, like a song by song review, you can go to gholy.com, see a written review. Part one and part two is right there, man. We got mad hits on that shit. I want to just thank and appreciate everybody for tuning into that. But I was going to do the review like I'm doing it right now, but I did it on the couple cast. Like, I do a couple cast on this same channel. So once we reviewed it there, and I already had a review on the website, I was like, I'm not going to continue. Like, I'm donned it out. You know what I'm saying? So here's the clip from the couple cast that you can watch the Donda review. And if you need to go more in depth, go to the site, check it out. And that's it. I'll let y'all.
So Donda leak. You heard
it. Oh, shit. Yeah. I don't even post. Can I say this legally?
Yeah, you could say.
I did. So on gholy.com, which is the site we own and run, we did a review on the Donda, and I listened to Donda a few times now, maybe like 4 or 5 times. I don't know if this is the final what's going to come out, but it seems like it, because when you go on Apple, it's 20 songs.
Yeah.
And also the one with Lil Baby and The Weeknd is leading the way, so it's on there. So it looks like that this is the album. I don't know if they'll retool it or.
What's your thoughts on it though? You fuck with it or not?
Yeah. So going into it, I didn't have any expectations, because you never know with Kanye.
Right.
Kanye could be a mixed bag. He could be college dropout. Kanye could be graduation. You never know what's going on. Like, you know what I'm saying? So I didn't go into it with any expectations, but what I came out with it from it with is that Kanye is very confused about who he wants to be as an artist. He's really confused about which Kanye is the best Kanye. And so you get bits and pieces of every Kanye, and then it just come out like a mixed bag. When if he would just let one Kanye dominate, then it would come out sounding either like Late Registration, College Dropout, Graduation, Life of Pablo, 808s and Heartbreaks. It just sounds like a culmination of all of those, and that's just a jumbled mess, you know what I'm saying? But it was some jewels in there. The joint with J-Lec and the Lox was probably one of my favorite songs. Ever. I'm gonna keep it real. Like, this is one of my favorite songs. This is one of the best songs I've ever heard. And the joint with Lil Baby in the Weeknd is cool. And the joint with Jay-Z I really like. But other than that, you know, it was cool. 5 other cool songs. It's probably like 12 trash joints. I ain't gonna hold you. Like, it's too many organs. It's too much. It's too church. It's
a lot of reverb on there, huh?
Yeah, it's a lot. I hope they fix it in the mix.
Yeah, I think it's interesting, because when you were talking about the different like personalities and energies or whatever, Kanye had me thinking about the movie when the dude got all them different personalities, and he started locking, he locked the girl up, and you know what I mean? And it's like the nice guy, the crazy one, the murderer. Exactly. Like, it's crazy. And it's
that's him
just
in
like,
the studio.
It's crazy. That's what I'm saying. It made me think of that. But yeah. I mean, we know for sure that Kanye loves his mom, and that's probably the purest energy we get from the album. And yeah, I don't know.
It's that always one joint a mixed Pusha bag. T, where Donda West, Dr. Donda West, Long Live, she is giving a speech at the beginning of the joint, and she like, well, you know, I'm Kanye's mom. And, you know, they said I could say anything up here. So, you know, this, that, and the third.
Yeah, I heard.
And that part might kind of bring you to tears, especially when the interlude where it's called Donda, and then you literally say Donda for 2 minutes.
Yeah.
It's like, that really did something to him. He really never been the same since then.
I think Kanye is this person that, like you said, has different sides. And, I mean, whether he deals with being bipolar or if that's just not true, I don't know. It's been put out by the family, you know, that he's a part of. Then again, maybe it's, you know,
propaganda.
Whatever. Who knows? Slander. But at the end of the day, what I do know is Kanye does feel hurt and sometimes misguided and emotional, and it's a lot.
All
and with
things,
the whole Kanye, the creative genius, it's a lot. Yeah. Me personally, I'm gonna say something that a lot of people not gonna rock with, but I haven't really connected with him since what? Graduation.
Graduation, you would say, right?
Yeah, graduation.
But I did and let you was, hear Pablo, and you did like a few joints.
I said
from Pablo.
It was cool, yeah. But it wasn't the Kanye that I felt when I heard College Dropout, and you know what I'm saying. It wasn't the Kanye that I was like, oh nah, you know what I mean. And Kanye knows that. I mean, you heard him say, you know, they want old Kanye. Yeah, we do. It is what it is.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But
I mean, I even that like was
the,
a very...
I like the older production that I used to get with Kanye.
See,
so
I don't
much.
Know though. Like it's dope. The old production is crazy. Mm-hmm. I think his production spawned the Dipset production. By the way, that Jay-Z Blueprint production. The Heat Makers came and took that and twisted it and made the Dipset production.
Right.
Like, it's so, I think Kanye is a real, real innovator, and that time was special. But I like the beats on the Pusha T album.
Yeah, that's true.
And I like the that era of my Dark Twisted Fantasy with the So Appalled and all that. Like,
but
he's
see,
got
real quick
eras.
Too about the genius of Kanye. I think Kanye suffers a lot with Jay Electronica suffered. You know, I've said that before. Like, I feel like there's
I don't
this,
even know how they got a song.
There's this madness, this creative madness where you want to perfect. And you do anything to get perfection, but there's always going to be a piece of you that says it's not perfect enough. And so you kind of get scrambled in your brain. And when it comes out, it comes out like chaos.
Yes.
And that's what
I'm thinking.
Feel.
You like that until I look at somebody like
it's
Kanye
you say, or
Dr.
Jay
Dr.
Electronica.
And
then you see Jay Electronica and it's like, okay, can we get the album? Can we get the album to get it? And it feels chaotic and it's like all
exactly.
scrambled. And
yeah.
it's like, I could see how he was reaching for perfection, and it creates a problem.
Yeah.
And I think that's what happens with the Kanye albums. It feels like some type of misfire or something where
yeah.
it's like, that's not it, right?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Sometimes the best way to create is somehow to be in some type of flow where you're not so in your mind and thinking about this has to be the biggest shit in the world.
The problem with that is Kanye feels like he has to be in his mind to create because he is a visionary. So
yeah.
many dope things have came from his mind. He's trying to tap into that for everything.
Now, I'm not going to lie. The thing about visionaries, like some of the greatest visionaries of our time, they miss.
A lot of
and
fails.
When they hit, it's the
fails.
Biggest thing
Facts.
In human history.
Facts.
So I'm not going to shit on him for that because that's a part of the process. But I do wish that he would just calm down. And I'm not, this sounds fucked up to say try to be normal. I don't want him to not be
crazy.
A genius.
To try to be normal.
But I just want him sometime to tone it down enough to just exist in some place where it's not chaotic.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I got it.
We was on this topic mad long.
Nothing has changed. It's going to be business as usual.
Welcome back to this real shit. You made it.
You made it.